नर्तकों की टोली कोई वाद्य यंत्र बजाता।
ये है उत्सव
है। सांस्कृतिक विरासत से ही बनता भारत श्रेष्ठ है,
बनता भारत श्रेष्ठ है, बनता भारत श्रेष्ठ है।
एक भारत श्रेष्ठ भारत, एक भारत श्रेष्ठ भारत।
Conducting this program not only to identify the talent but to preserve our cultural heritage, our art, craft, dance, music, theater, and also we want to promote it and we want to disseminate it among the students, and ultimately we want to integrate it with teaching learning. In this direction we have done a lot of work. When it was started in 15, our intention was to identify the talents and also to create awareness among the school students. You know, it is meant for the secondary school students, students who are studying in class 9, 10, 11, 12, they are participating in this program. This secondary, for the secondary school students, and we have identified themes that you know, it is on art, it is on music, and both vocal and instrumental, and also dance, these four areas. But initially when it was started, theater also was a part of this, and at that time our focus was more on group activities. Now we are conducting some solo activities to identify the talent so that in future we can nurture these talents. And this program is unique in the sense that we are trying to identify and also we are trying to disseminate. We have disseminated. You might be knowing we are conducting one NISTA program all over the country. This is a teacher training program for the elementary level, and our target is to reach 42 lakhs teachers, and we have already launched this program in 30 states, completed in 21 states, and it will not only help in the development of this aesthetic sensibility, rather it will help in the development of creativity, it will help in the development of critical thinking, it will help in the development of problem solving ability. What we need in 21st century, these are the learning skills we need and we expect our children should achieve, and that will help them to develop their innate potentialities and contribute significantly in nation building. See, in our country, in elementary level and secondary level, but we have around 26 crore students. And if we can make our students more creative, more innovative through this art and craft, through music, through dance, by integrating it, because our intention is not only to promote, not only to preserve, but to integrate, disseminate, so that everybody will participate, the awareness will be created among the people and among the students, among the teachers, and in the community. Everybody will know different art form, everybody will know the art, craft, music, dance, and they will take maximum advantage. And when we are engaged, involved in art and craft, and we forget everything and we enjoy learning, and learning becomes meaningful. When it is meaningful, it becomes an integral part of cognitive structure, and our students never forget. And we are going to implement that in our schools, in teaching learning process, empowering our teacher by conducting training program. And it is from 15 we started, and before that, of course, we had taken some initiative in art integrated learning. Now we have come out with the guidelines package, and that definitely it is going to bring about a significant change in teaching learning process, and it will help in improving the quality of education in our country, and it will reduce the dropout rate. And that we have also experienced in some of the blocks. When we are implementing this, students are more motivated, they are coming to the school, they are enjoying learning. So we have to take advantage of this art, craft, music, theater, drama, everything. And this is high time we should realize the importance of this. I'm really thankful to the members of jury who have come from different parts of the country just to assess the performance of our students, identify the talents. But I would like to congratulate all of you, particularly the students, the special needs students who have participated in these programs. I request all of you to give a big hand to the students who have come from different part of the country. And I would like to mention that you all are winners. And you all are winners. You have participated at the block level, district level, state level, and you have come to the national level. You all are winners. And we want to develop the feeling of cooperation, not competition. And we are conducting this solo competition, identify the talent, but our purpose is to develop fellow feeling, belongingness, cooperation, so that in future you will be good citizen of this country, you will imbibe all the human values, and that will be a significant contribution in nation building. That is our expectation, and I welcome you all to this Kala Utsav, and I hope all of you will enjoy this program. And I am very happy to be here because Bhopal is my place. I was here, and I whenever I come here, I feel emotional because I say this is my second home. I belong to Odisha, but my education, service, everything I did from here. I started from here. So that is why I am very happy to be here. And once again, I welcome you all. Thank you.
Shiksha mein नंबरों की दौड़ जो कुछ समय से चल रही थी, उसके कारण से बच्चे, इवन जो उनके घर में शिक्षा, कला के शिक्षा जो मौजूद है, उससे भी वंचित रह जाते हैं, क्योंकि उन्हें किसी न किसी तरह से ये रहता है कि हमें बहुत अच्छे अंक पाने हैं कुछ विषयों में. पर ये देखा गया है ओवर अ पीरियड कि जो बच्चों का सोशियो इमोशनल डेवलपमेंट है, जिसके प्रोफेसर सेनापति ने यहाँ बात करी कि ये केवल शिक्षा में कुछ आंकड़े अचीव करने, कुछ अंक अचीव करने तक की बात नहीं है, एक पूर्ण व्यक्तित्व की बात है. तो ये जो पूर्ण व्यक्तित्व का आस्पेक्ट है, जो एक पहलू है, ये कहीं ना कहीं कला ना होने के कारण से छूटा जा रहा था, जिसके लिए कला शिक्षा विभाग कला शिक्षा कार्य कर रहे थे. पर जो कला उत्सव ने अपनी भूमिका निभाई है वो आप सबके सामने है. आप सब जानते हैं कि लाखों बच्चे स्कूल लेवल, ब्लॉक लेवल, डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल और फिर राज्य जो हमारे हैं, जो स्टेट लेवल के कंपटीशन है, उसमें भाग लेते हैं. शायद ही हमारे विद्यालयों में कोई ऐसा टीचर या कर्मचारी या पेरेंट्स होंगे जिन्हें ये पता नहीं होगा कि कला उत्सव एक उत्सव है जिसमें देश भर से बच्चे भाग लेते हैं. तो ये है इस पर्टिकुलर इवेंट का, इस कला उत्सव की महत्ता, कि हर जगह इसके साथ बच्चे बड़े जुड़ते चले जा रहे हैं, जो ना केवल यहाँ पर, यहाँ से जो पूरे देश भर की कला संस्कृति और जो व्यवहार लेके देख के जा रहे हैं, उसे अपने अपने स्कूलों में और अपने अपने साथियों के साथ साझा करेंगे.
देश के निवासी सभी जाने रंग रूप वेश भाषा चाहे
is the, a country, a nation, which is abundant in various forms of art and culture. From north to south, to east to west, to northeast, everywhere you find that each region, each people has their own art and culture, has their own traditions, their dances, costumes, language, their different art and paintings, and their music. And we are here to celebrate this in Kala Utsav. This is where we really want to showcase the different art forms in different parts of the country and see that the very best of the best come forward and we can nurture them in the days ahead.
First of all, let me congratulate the Department of School Education and Literacy for thinking of such a beautiful concept of bringing together children from all over the country in one place and to encourage and nurture the arts. What we have seen across the world is that wherever children are learning music and arts along with their studies, their performance is much better. They do better in mathematics, they do better in science, because the same part of the brain is stimulated when you learn classical music, when you learn classical dance. So you cannot separate the studies and the sciences and the more difficult concepts with art and culture. It's all part of the same thing. And every time you integrate it all together,
I am very happy and I congratulate ministry for understanding our strength to organize Kala Utsav. Out of 5 Kala Utsav, 3 were organized in New Delhi, and we have organized 2. This is the second.